So hi, David.
Hi, Ed. How are you doing?
Yeah, good. We're here with your lovely array of Ranger FX pedals, and you've got a new reverb pedal, right?
That's right. This is the Reverb X, which is a digital reverb pedal. It's based around the idea of when you plug in your pedals in the wrong order and you have an overdrive after the reverb, and the reverb sounds epic. It's huge and full of texture and detail. So with this, there's an overdrive circuit after the reverb, and you dial it in with this knob here, so that's all clean, that's all distorted. All the time, the original signal is unchanged, no distortion, and always present. You can't dial out the original signal. But it adds a real graininess and texture, if you want, to the sound. But things could get quite noisy in that situation, so I put in a noise gate, which you can switch to be post reverb and overdrive. And so when you're playing, you might be playing a long line, and it will, when you stop playing, it will just chop off the end of the sound in a dramatic way.
So you're just completely cutting off the reverb tail?
Yes, you could have it set to the full 6 second long reverb and play a long reverby flowing line. But as soon as you stop, you get this sharp cut. You switch in the gate for one of the switches at the end here. And also, it comes with Igor, which is a pressure pad controller. There it is. It's a little pressure pad designed to go hard, shiny side up on a hard stage. If you're barefoot or sitting down, you flip over for the more sensitive side. And when you plug that in, you get no reverb until you start leaning on the controller, and then a bloom of reverb appears around the notes you're playing. Or you could have the gate in as well, and you'll get the reverb and chopped off, and then you go back to completely dry. There's two flavours of reverb. You've got bright and immediate, or dark with some pre-delay. And it's the texture it adds to chords. When it's chopped off, it's almost like a mellotron or something, like a keyboard pad behind the sound you're playing.
So,
about it.
Have you tried it on any other instruments as opposed to just guitar?
No, I haven't. I haven't put down the guitar. When I made this, I just every day at about 6 o'clock I had to play for this one like an hour. So it was so distracting. But it sounds wicked, and it makes things sound as if, in some settings, like it's a guitar sample, like edited, and the graininess makes it sound like an old guitar sample, if you want, you know, or a sample from the live bootleg. And I think that's a nice new kind of approach to it. It's quite simple how it works, but you get these really neat, it's like a modern take on an 80s gated reverb.
Yeah, so I think it would be really interesting on like a drum machine or something like that.
Yeah, because it would be great, yes, because it adds a really distinct short tail to things.
So is it available now?
Yes, that's right. We're launching it at NAMM. We've got a whole shelf of them back in London. And it's in our usual custom enclosures. No sockets on the side, so it fits into a tiny little hole with all the sockets on the end there. And you get an overload LED, just so if you do want clean reverb, you turn off the distortion knob and make sure the overload LED isn't on a lot. And you can do a regular clean reverb with no gate, and it sounds wicked.
Cool. Well, thank you very much for talking to us. Oh, one more thing. How much is it?
It's $193.
Excellent.
Including the Eagle.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.
No problem.